Hi everyone, I'm Sarah Sneed, President and CEO of the NEA Foundation, and I want to thank you for choosing this session focused on how community schools are making effective use of ARPA and other federal funds. We know that community schools are one of the most effective evidence-based strategies for advancing educational equity and supporting student learning and student success. But for those of you who may be a little less familiar, community schools represent a strategy where a school blends and braids and integrates into one comprehensive whole, a whole set of resources, supports, activities, and opportunities for student learning and student success. At the heart of each community school is a strong instructional core and quality teaching. But at a community school, aligned and integrated with that instructional core are four elements commonly referred to as the four pillars of community schools. These are student supports, extended and expanded learning, family school and community partnership, and collaborative leadership. As community schools mature, they become true hubs of the community and community life, where families and the community as a whole, as well as students, can access resources, supports, and opportunities. Each community school is distinct, and that's because community schools are developed to be responsive to the distinct needs, resources, assets, interests, priorities of the community where they're situated. But all share the four pillars in common and that authentic practice of partnership and the partners' shared vision for student learning and student success. Research shows that community schools significantly improve children's educational experiences and their outcomes. The ARPA funds, as you have heard throughout this summit, can be used comprehensively to support the development of community schools. Some examples, just a few examples, include using them to support planning for needs and assets assessments, to build an infrastructure for community schools, to bring on a community school coordinator who can blend the resources and opportunities into that comprehensive whole, and of course, for the actual resources, services, and activities. Let's take a look at how community schools around the country are making effective use of ARPA funds.
Hi everyone, it's Mayor Michelle Wu. Thank you so much to the U.S. Department of Education for inviting the Boston Public Schools to be part of this summit. Boston Community Hub Schools pairs a national community schools model with our district and citywide commitment to racial equity. We invite the community to partner with us to empower our students and families to ensure that schools are aligned with the community's wants and needs. Those directly impacted and their lived experiences are at the heart of this collaboration. Our community hub schools encourage students to analyze and challenge the practices, policies, and philosophies that perpetuate systemic inequities. That's why we've invested in social workers, family liaisons, hub school managers, and professional development on restorative justice. Because when we all, as a community, come together to uplift one another, we can drive tremendous change. That's what we're hoping to accomplish through our Community Hub Schools pilot, with the leadership of Assistant Superintendent Elich Naheli Tawora and her focus on critical pedagogy and anti-racist leaders and systems. The YMCA of Greater Boston is a lead partner in the Boston Community Hub School strategy. We're very fortunate to have dedicated partners throughout the city with whose support we can prepare our students for every opportunity.
Well, welcome, bienvenidos again, and thank you to our school teams for the great work that they're doing. We're so excited about this pilot. My name is Elich Nayeli Tabora. I have the honor of being a parent and product of Boston Public Schools, but also I am serving as the assistant superintendent, working with some incredible partners and an incredible team leading this strategy to really shift how we think about and how we implement and culturally and linguistically sustaining practice and in students. I want to give a thank you to our partners at YMCA of Greater Boston and also the Boston Teachers Union for being strong advocates for this strategy. We have a long history in Boston of doing community schools from Freedom Schools onward. And really, this is our opportunity to really shift the paradigm, to stop talking about students can only learn if, but saying students can learn hard stop. And we also have to mitigate for the inequities that exist in their lives that are no fault of their own, no fault of our students, no fault of our families and our communities, and honor, recognize the incredible talent, the wealth, the community cultural wealth that exists, and leverage that so that students can really be activist transformers of their realities, not just passive participants. And so that's the promise of the Boston Community Hub School strategy. And I'm excited to introduce the women who are leading the implementation of this work, Renee Omalade and Claire Kaiser, and I'll pass it on to them.
My name is Renee Omalade. I'm the director of Boston Community Hub Schools for Boston Public Schools.
And my name is Claire Kaiser, and I'm the association director for Community Hub Schools with the YMCA of Greater Boston.
We're excited to have done a joint hiring process for our Boston Community Hub School coordinators with the YMCA of Greater Boston.
And we're really proud of this equity-driven process and the fact that our hiring committee consisted of students, parents, faith-based partners, folks from BPS Central Office, folks from the YMCA, and from the Boston Teachers Union as well.
And through this process, we were able to onboard 11 coordinators that reflect the students that we serve, folks who are BIPOC, who are multilingual, and who are alum of Boston Public Schools.
We're also really proud of the community of practice we've built through a learning network that is connected with both the YMCA and BPS. Our coordinators work together, learn together, and we're really building a community so that our school communities can be connected across our network of the 14 Boston Community Hub Schools.
And this really provides an opportunity for us to improve learning and academics for our young people. And we're thankful for this opportunity that was funded through the ARP ESSER funding. And lastly, we would love to acknowledge the land that we are coming to you all from in Boston, Massachusetts, Massachusetts land, the Pawtucket land, and the Wampanoag land. Thank you very much from Boston.
Thank you.
So, now let's see what the Burke High, Muniz Academy, and Hernandez teams have to share about our promising pilot program.
And next you'll hear from the team at the Jeremiah E. Burke High School.
Let me first start by introducing myself. My name is Dr. Linza McIntyre, secondary school superintendent at Boston Public Schools. However, having said that, I served in the capacity of school leader at the Jeremiah E. Burke High School for approximately 10 years. That schools should not be siloed from the community, in that one person could not efficiently and effectively meet the needs of everybody. And so I began to think of ways to democratize school as part of a community process. And as a result, I found what was then we talked about as full service community schools. And I'll share with you the one thing that I think is really important for a leader to know about developing partnerships under hub schooling is that as much as you need to be, I think, confident in what you know, you also have to be willing to face your vulnerabilities and not be afraid of them. Because it is through those vulnerabilities that you are able to build relevant and meaningful connections that reflect the work that needs to be done with community partners. So one of the things I think that many people forget to do when they bring in partners is hold them to the same level of accountability that you are held to as a school leader, right? And so it is through the integration of the partner in the school community and the accountability that allows the growth to take place. And so through that clear line of communication with an accountability metrics to it, we were able to celebrate our success with our partners, but also course correct in areas that did not meet the the desired outcomes. And the way that I see myself supporting student success is first and foremost talking with the students and getting their input on what success means to them and what they define success as. So many times when it comes to higher education, we define success as being able to get into a college or a university or finding a career path after. But I want to first talk to our students and figure out what success means to them. And then from there, asking them, well, what can I do as a support to make sure that you are reaching the success that you want to reach? So my job here is to make sure that we are continuing to hold the partners that we have now to a higher standard, making sure that they are adhering to our students' reasons of success and wanting to be successful. And that's also listening to our students if we need to add more partners or bring in more program that would help them become successful. My job is just to be an asset and to listen to the needs and also understand that our students are, as much as we need them, they need us, and making sure that I'm also using their amazing qualities that they have to expand our program and our hub schools strategy here at the Burke.
And next, a word from our school, the Margarita Muniz Academy.
Good morning. I am Dania Vasquez. I am the head of school for the Margarita Muniz Academy, the only dual language high school in the New England region. We're really excited about our hub school coordinator and the strategy that we're about to launch. Our school has been engaged in developing its portrait of the graduate over the last year and a half. And part of the implementation phase that we are now entering is building our city as campus model. And Erica will be really a key member to that team as part of her core work. And our city as campus model really is about community place-based learning, engaging partners in the curriculum, making sure that teachers and students see learning opportunities outside of the walls of the school. And so as a community partner, as a hub school coordinator, Erica brings that expertise of understanding and knowing Boston, understanding and knowing families and partners, and also because she has some teaching background. And so she has a very unique possibility and lens that she brings to our community. One of the goals of the hub school work is centered on liberatory education. And so the idea of merging our city as campus model, where learning can happen in school and out of school, is really meeting that particular goal of liberatory education. If we can get this right, it will elevate student achievement because we will have our students much more engaged, much more interested in their own learning, because learning will be about the things that matter to them. Learning will be relevant. And we also believe that the Boston community will begin to understand and value who our students are, so that it becomes a reciprocal engagement. Students understanding who they are and their place in the community, and Boston understanding and valuing our community. And that's a win-win, and we can only have higher achievement and more success with our students. So we're really excited about this opportunity.
Gwen.
Buenos dias, mi nombre es Erika Castro, and I'm the new community hub school coordinator at the Margarita Muniz. Join a strong community that has a strong sense of pride and is collaborative and understands the importance of hearing everybody's voice and teamwork and pushing the vision of what the school is and the goals that we're trying to reach. I love that the school community has a strong sense of not only community within the school, but the strong sense and connection outside of the school, and that we bring in our alum and that we understand that their voices matter just as much as our current students. In addition to that, part of my work in trying to elevate what's happening at the Margarita Muniz is to hear our students' voices, our family voices, and all of our stakeholders, in knowing that in order to grow our school as a community and grow our students and our portrait of a graduate, we need to understand that everybody's voice matters. They themselves, their identity matter, in order to see themselves in, within the work that we're doing here and the work that they're trying to do outside of the school.
When I look at my students, they're all students of color, and I think it's important that this feels like a space where they can feel heard and seen. So currently I have some artwork that's not covered up by instruments, but all the artwork in this class is of people of color, right? The artist that I've been following on Instagram for a while, she focuses her art on black and brown folks, and you see the texture of the hair, like she is fearless and so are you, like y'all are rocking the afro, you know what I mean? So all of these pieces of art have some sort of like affirmation. And so I constantly try to do that with my students, just speaking positively to them and just acknowledging them as their whole selves and how they come in.
And now we'll hear from the Rafael Hernandez.
So when we were asked about what our school's vision for the Boston Community Hub school strategy was, my first thought is that it's actually quite simple. The idea is to have a hub, a place where families feel like they get the support and the net, the safety net in order to be able to survive in a really challenging city. And that safety net actually ensures that what we can keep the focus on in classrooms is student learning and achievement and growth. So our vision for partnerships in a hub school model is to make it impossible to fail. So as a family, if you need a thing, we've got your back. And if you acknowledge and are with in partnership with our work in that respect, you are more likely to want to engage in a conversation about how do we then push your child, not just to survival, but to excellence. So the idea is to build that safety net of partnerships that build capacity for families, not just to survive, but to thrive academically, and to also be involved with us as like full life partners in this really beautiful, very holistic way. We were also asked to think about academic achievement in this conversation as well. And I think the primary purpose of having a hub is to think about all of the possibilities of what children could be or dream about becoming, not only because we've got that safety net in place, but also our partnerships that we bring into the building with Brandel are designed to help people dream big beyond survival and into thriving. So I think a lot of, I mean, Brandel, you can probably speak to this, but the direction that we're moving in next year, because we started in the middle of COVID thinking about how do you create food security, housing, social services, school psychologists full-time, and then external partnerships with folks who could take care of mental health in the aftermath of the pandemic, or in the middle of it, quite frankly, still. Step two is thinking about once you've got these partnerships and relationships built, year two is all about having the beautiful capacity of having a human being who can help us think about what does it mean to drive the work academically for kids so that they create this narrative for themselves as college going and career ready. And honestly, it's Boston. Out here, you can dream big. You've got all kinds of really interesting industries that you can tap into. And schools typically and traditionally don't have the human energy to be able to run all of these ripe conversations that are ready to happen in public-private partnerships. And we're incredibly lucky to have a human being who specializes in just that.
My name is Brandel Delgado, and I'm the Boston Community Hub School Coordinator here at the Rafael Hernandez K-8 Dual Language School. And I have Carolina here by my side, principal.
So Brandel, tell us a little bit about how you see your role supporting student success.
So how I see my role supporting student success is, you know, just being a positive figure and being around all the students so I can potentially help them and gain their trust so they can come to me for whatever reason the need be, right? So if they need anything from school academically, they need any help, I can sit down with them. I'm usually in the cafeteria in the morning where I can talk to a lot of the students when they go down to the bathroom. I'm doing my work, but in the meantime, I'm also helping them and gaining their trust throughout the day. I go out during their recess time. I chaperone them through lunchtime to make sure that everything's well, become familiar with figures since I came in mid-year. And that has been going well. I get bullied into playing kickball every day or football and get asked every day if I'm not busy so I can go out with them. So I think that's a success on my end.
So Brandel is doing a phenomenal job of building relationships and building his buy-in and trust with the community as like a precondition to thinking about what's the partnership that we need in order to make this work. Mm-hmm. But then tell us a little bit about like your daily duties. Like what are you doing day in and day out vis-a-vis partners?
So I do a lot of meetings. I do a lot of check-ins with the partners. I don't turn down a meeting with a partner. I want to see where their head's at. I want to see what they bring to our community. I want to see how they envision themselves collaborating with us and just becoming one with our school and helping our students in every level that they can. So that's basically what I do throughout the day. And then also just following through, figuring out what are the student needs and what they can bring to the table and potentially bring them in throughout the school, and then hopefully bring them in the next year as well.
Tell us a little bit about how we think we could elevate student and family voices in your role specifically.
Yeah. I think it's important, one, to gain the trust of the families here. A lot of the Hispanic families that we have in the school, they don't really just open up because it's just something that we have. We're very prideful. We don't want to say what we're going through. So getting to know them, being, again, a familiar face, being outside during dismissal with the K-1 kids, the first graders, they're very young. So when the families see that their children can confide in me to walk them outside, they talk to me, they know that I'm a familiar face and they can come and talk to me. They wouldn't feel scared. They wouldn't feel intimidated. Embarrassed sometimes. So gaining that trust slowly would allow me to get them to that point where I could sit down with them and ask them what they need and figure out what they need, and hopefully being able to help them in the future. So just being around them is just a great feeling.
Tell me a little bit, because you've got a whole network of coordinators, hub school coordinators, and you are in a special position of being one of our dual language school hub school coordinators. So mm-hmm. How's that job different for you?
For me, So my work is different from my fellow colleagues, the other Boston Community Hub coordinators and all the other schools, is the fact that I have to be much more intentional when I'm reaching out to partners and bringing them into the building. I have to make sure that, one, that they're dual language. A lot of our students, a lot of our families speak Spanish. So it's important that they can understand who is serving their child while they're in school. So if the parent can't speak to our partners, it kind of serves no purpose because they won't know what's going on. So in order to help and assist the whole child, we need everybody to be involved and everybody to understand each other. And speaking Spanish is one of the best ways to do that, because that's what our families speak and our students.
Hello, I'm Laura Howard, Community Schools Coordinator for Batesville School District, located in the state of Arkansas. The COVID pandemic has impacted our lives in so many ways. It has especially impacted our students emotionally, physically, and academically. Community Schools model offers an evidence-based approach to help schools recover and accelerate student successes. Batesville School District has been involved in this work for the last few years. In fact, in the spring of 2021, we worked alongside Arkansas Senator Missy Urban and Forward Arkansas to get Act 744 on the books. Act 744 establishes community schools model as a state-level strategy for school improvement and provides a framework for schools to use if they choose to implement community schools model. Our mission here in Batesville School District is to coordinate relationships and resources through a public school that focus on academics, health and social support, youth and community developments, and family and community engagement. When we began implementing community schools model, we set out about this work with a few goals in mind. We wanted our children to enter school to be ready to learn and to attend school consistently and succeed academically. We wanted schools to be engaged with families and their communities, and we wanted families and students to be engaged in their education and involved in their learning and with their community. We want students that are healthy, both physically, socially, and emotionally. We want to prepare students to be college, career, and civic-ready students. We want to build strong families and healthy communities so that our community is a desirable place to live. Here in the Batesville School District, we are braiding together a range of supports and opportunities personalized to our students and their families. We are doing this work around the four pillars of community schools. For example, in Pillar 1, Integrated Student Supports, you'll see that we offer telemedicine clinics and immunization clinics, food pantry and backpack programs, and school-based mental health services. Under Pillar 2, Expand and Enrich Learning, you'll see that we have transition camps and summer camps and after-school programs. Under Pillar 3, Engage Families and Communities, you'll see that we have an outstanding Blue Ribbon home visiting team that serves students before birth through age 4. Also, we have Pioneer Parent Academy that was created because of the COVID pandemic. Knowing that we were not able to bring families into our buildings for learning opportunities, we took those 2 families through video recorded sessions that we posted on social media and archived on our website and shared with families through our Remind system. We also utilize needs assessment surveys to address needs and concerns within our district that we take from faculty, students, and parents. Under Pillar 4, Leading Collaboration, you'll see that we have multiple opportunities to collaborate with our stakeholders, from health and wellness committees to family and community engagement committees, even city and community advisory teams. The American Rescue Plan funds that were designed to support schools across the United States have been especially impactful as we implement community schools models, Pillars 1 and 2. Under Pillar 1, Integrated Student Support, we're able to hire an additional school nurse. This nurse became our COVID point of contact for students and families and helped coordinate free COVID vaccination clinics. We were also able to use the funds to purchase community center memberships for all of our teachers and staff and all students 13 and older. This was designed to provide mental and physical health support for our teachers, staff, and students. Under Pillar 2, American Rescue Plan funds were used to help us create Pioneer Virtual Academy. This allowed us to hire a coordinator that coordinated all virtual learning opportunities for our students K through 12, whether they were fully online or remote learners. Also, this person was able to provide support for virtual students and their families. We also utilized these funds to purchase hotspots for students that did not have Wi-Fi within their homes, and we purchased additional Chromebooks to support our one-to-one initiative. American Rescue Plan funds were also used to purchase digital resources, such as online curriculums and digital libraries, and it allows us to provide summer school sessions for the school years 21 and 22. These 4-week summer sessions are designed to address learning loss with our students grades K through 12. They provide remediation and enrichment and credit recovery opportunities. The American Rescue Plan funds provided an investment into public schools that helps address gaps in educational opportunity and outcomes, not just during the COVID pandemic, but for years to come.
I would also like to take a moment to acknowledge and thank the NEA Foundation for their support and technical assistance they have provided during our community schools journey. This partnership has made a huge difference in our ongoing work to remove barriers to learning while supporting our students, families, and our community. The NEA Foundation has allowed us to access multiple national resources that have helped to accelerate our work. Thank you, NEA Foundation.
If you would like more information about what you've heard today, please don't hesitate to contact me using the information on this slide. Thank you so much.